So in part four to this multi-part I already fucked it up. Right after you said you have a really good system. Yeah, but I wish I could talk. I wish I knew how to talk right. Okay. Alright. Hey fellow beauty finders, it's Mathias Allen, otherwise known as mathias4makeup on all social media, and I'm so excited in today's Monday Makeup Chat, I'm going to be sitting down with Nick Lujan, who is an amazing makeup artist. He has traveled the world, and we have a ton of information to share with you today. We are going to be talking about the importance of powder, or the not importance of powder. Do you need loose powder?
What are the results that your clients want, or you want, out of your makeup? Do you want your makeup to stand all day long? Do you want a matte finish? Or do you want to be fresh and maybe just have to touch up in certain spots?
Okay.
So that's really important.
Because now, let's talk about tools, because there are different ways to apply loose powder. And like Nick just said, it's very important to be strategic with how you're using your powder or how you're packing your brush. These tips are going to be so important for you guys to learn.
Okay. Yeah.
So teach us.
Let's do it. Let's go through it. So there's a million ways to pick up and use a powder. But from my perspective as the artist, when I'm working on set, the best way is to use a small tool. So this is one of my friend Rocky's brushes. He's Cosette brushes. Mm-hmm. I love this brush for detail work and for really precisely placing powder. Mm-hmm. And the best way to load it is to take a little powder on your brush. So I'm taking a little bit. There's a little too much, which happens a lot, ladies and gents.
And might I point out the fact that he picked up the top of the loose powder and he did not dip into the loose powder to get product on the brush. He's using what's in the top of the lid already. So, I mean, that's very right there. He's being very strategic with not getting too much powder on his tool.
This is enough powder for like a week of application in your lid, so you don't need that much.
That's like 2 hours for me.
What skincare are you using? I want to know.
I'm super oily. Okay.
I wish I was oily. Okay, let's focus. Okay, so you load your brush, but what happens? You dip in your product, and then you have all this product sitting on the tip of your brush. Mm-hmm. You can even see it if you're looking up against my hand. So what you want to do then is not take it to the skin, because you'll get a dry patch. So you want to work it inside the bristles. See how I'm working it in the bristles? Mm-hmm. Now when you look at the brush, it looks like a brush that you possibly used yesterday and just didn't clean.
Yeah, a little light dusting.
It's a little light dusting. But with this tool, I can now go through and just press and roll on the nasolabial fold right here. That's where you get some unwanted shine.
The shine right here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is more of a strategic placement. So this is great for like photography, editorial, or even snapping a selfie if you just want to do a little slight shine control in these areas, that way you don't get flashback. Then there's another technique. So this is what I would use for like red carpet, or even like if I'm going to the office for the day and I know I need my makeup to stay on right away from the very, very get-go. Mm-hmm. I would use a different brush. I would use a bigger brush. Again, a fluffier powder brush. Same company. This is my friend Rocky's. I would load the brush the same way. I'm picking up a little extra powder this time because of the size of the tool. So look how much powder's on there. And if you look at the tool, it's uneven. You'll see where there's a lot of product. Mm-hmm. And a little tiny bit of product, and then there's areas where there's no product at all. So when you go to put that on the face, you're going to get blotches.
Right. It's going to be heavy right there, but not right there.
Exactly.
Right next to it, an inch away. Right. So look what he's doing.
Same technique. You work it in the bristles, and then without disturbing the makeup, because if you put a lot of pressure, you're going to disturb your makeup. It's going to move and transfer. You're going to do just a light beat of the mug, and that gets the powder to lay on the skin without disturbing your makeup. Again, clean your brush, and then you can dust off excess. So this is a softer application for powder. But let's say you're doing
Mathias, the oil slick of all.
Mathias's makeup. You're going out in Las Vegas. You need that makeup to look good when you stayed up all night the next morning.
Yeah.
I'm going to switch tools.
My favorite. This is my best friend.
I love a puff. A puff is what I learned with. It's really unique. And when you load your puff, you're not going to just go straight to the face, because all that powder is going to fall on your outfit. Mm-hmm. Especially if you're wearing that really fancy designer outfit to go out and party. So what you want to do is work the product inside the puff. See how I'm folding it in half like a little taco? Mm-hmm. And all that product is getting worked into the bristle.
I'm sure some ladies out there are thinking this. It's similar to like when you get a stain on a shirt and you spray stain remover on that fabric and you're trying to work that stain remover into the fabric. So just think of it that way when you're loading your puff. It's like getting the stain remover into the fabric before you wash that fabric.
I love that. Such a good analogy. It's perfect.
Thank you.
And then the same technique where you do just a light pat. This is where the term beating the mug comes from. I'm beating my mug with a little bit of powder, but no pressure. No pressure. We just want to put a thin layer of powder over everything just to protect our makeup so that now we can reload our puff again and support with our fingers in the back and apply pressure to really push that product into the skin and make it long wearing.
But because he lightly beat the entire complexion, he got a very soft light layer over the entire surface of the face. So when he went in for the second helping of powder and he pressed, there's not gonna be that kind of problem of the powder just grabbing onto the liquid foundation or the cream foundation or the concealer, because there's a light dusting of powder which is laid down almost like a safety blanket.
Precisely. That, we're a good team here at explaining things. I really enjoy that.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's different from baking. Baking's a whole other story. This is more up-to-date modern technology and I think technique. And another pro tip, when you're using your powder, let's say you accidentally dab into your lipstick and you get a red spot of lipstick, you don't want to powder your forehead because it will transfer, right?
Why not? I do that all the time.
Then you're going to have to color correct.
I just work it down into the blush area.
This blew my mind when somebody, I saw somebody do this backstage. They took their puff and they had a red dot, so they just flipped it around. And the other side. How did I never know that before? Oh my gosh, the simple things in life.
So I hope we were able to help you ladies out there who are wondering, like, do I need loose powder or do I need setting powder? You know, I personally am really thankful that you did help answer my question, because I do get that a lot on my social media. Now, do you like to interact with your fans on social media?
Absolutely. If you follow me on YouTube, Instagram, you ever have questions, DM me directly. And takes me a minute to get back sometimes because I travel, but I will get back to you, I promise.
Oh, so you guys follow him on all social media. I'm putting all of his links down in the description. He's gonna be back on my YouTube channel in an upcoming Monday Makeup Chat. We're gonna take this series train as far as we can take it before he has to fly back to New York. So I appreciate him being here today. I appreciate you all for watching. Please do click thumbs up if you did enjoy this pro makeup artist quick tips video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you next time. Bye, you guys.